now, here's your host, Andy Kaufman.
Welcome, Mr. Andy Kaufman.
Andy Kaufman.
And now, Andy Kaufman.
One for the money, two for the show, three to get ready, now go, can't go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything, but take me over my blue suede shoe.
Moving around, goes in, buys in with a hit scissor. Deep take.
Step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything, but take me over my blue suede shoe. Let's go. Blue suede shoes, baby. Blue suede shoes. Well, you can do anything, but stay home for my blue suede shoe.
Now, hello, this is my special and it's for 90 minutes. ABC told me that I'm special, and so, you know, they give me $100,000 and they say, you can do whatever you want with this money. So I was supposed to, you know, hire writers and guests. But I was so lazy, and so, you know, I did not do it.
Andy Kaufman is a comedian, performer, and one of the most influential minds, I think, of probably the last 50 or 60 years.
Andy Kaufman's he was a comedian, kind of a writer, performer, who was really popular in the late 70s and early 80s and is famous for playing a lot of pranks.
If I had said, I'm sorry, but I need my money for I need it myself, I have some, but I don't want to give it to you, they would have said, you know, but I said,
I'm sorry, I don't have no money. I don't have nothing. I don't know what to do. Leave me alone.
And they said, all right, listen, here, you want some money?
Andy Kaufman was his own man. If you want to describe anybody that in the history of the entertainment business, who was just true to themselves in every aspect of the Andy Kaufman, if I had to describe who Andy Kaufman was, I'd say he was his own man.
Just a lot of absurdist type of humor, a lot of surrealistic.
Tony Clifton has just completed a very successful engagement at Harrah's in Tahoe, has recently opened for Rodney Dangerfield and Andy Kaufman, and will soon be appearing at the Tropicana in Las Vegas. Please welcome international singing sensation, the world-famous Tony Clifton.
Oh, Tony Clifton was Andy's imaginary friend.
Tony Clifton was a character of Andy Kaufman's.
Tony Clifton was a character that reportedly Andy Kaufman and Bob Zmuda like sort of co-created, and they used to both perform.
Tony Clifton is supposedly the alter ego of Andy Kaufman. He was like a fat lounge singer.
I've got to be
first time I ever saw Andy Kaufman was on Taxi, because my dad was a huge Taxi fan. He always watched it at Naked Night. I think it was on like 10 o'clock.
It's all. You don't need anything else. You need the friends, the food and the clothes, the car, the house with the pool, the beautiful woman that make the foam come out of the mouth. You know, as long as you have the house with the pool, the car, and the beautiful woman, the friends would only get in the way. Forget I said anything. I don't know what I'm talking about.
I remember exactly when I first saw Andy Kaufman. I was, it was 1992. I was 9 or 10 years old at the time. My family had just gotten cable. So I was watching Comedy Central.
You know, I'm not trying to show any talent. I'm not trying to. All I'm trying to do is have some fun. This is when I get together with friends and we go home and I have some fun. And I just wanted to make believe you were my friends and we're having a good time. It doesn't work. I have no business being here, and I want to thank you all for showing me where I'm at. You really showed me where I'm at today. I was just trying to do my best. I just want to ruin everything. Every time I try to go wrong, I was just trying to do my best.
Thank you very much.
And I, again, I was so young, I didn't really get it, but it made me laugh so hard.
Blue, open the sky. It's bird. It's plane. Nope, it's Superman. Yep, Superman. Strange visitor from another planet came to Earth with powers and abilities far beyond old mold me.
I don't think it's too naive to label Andy Kaufman as just a comedian, because what else was he?
I think it's naive to label him as a stand-up comic.
When we say comedian, we usually think about stand-up, and Andy Kaufman definitely started as a stand-up.
The guy was a successful actor. I mean, he was on one of the biggest shows on television at the time. He didn't do a lot of movies or anything, but you know, he was a club performer, but he was also an actor, and he was probably more well known for acting than he was for stand-up.
So Andy Kaufman would do a thing where he would challenge women at live events to wrestle him, and he would do it. I believe he would do it at pro wrestling matches. He would invite women from the audience to come. And you know, any woman can wrestle me, and he calls him the intergender champion of wrestling, because you know, he was the only man wrestling women anywhere ever.
Yeah, I saw on TV that he would challenge women, he would call women out and say that if they, you know, if they really were equal to men, they could wrestle men, and then he would wrestle them and pin them down, and like they would get really pissed off, and it was impossible to tell whether it was planned or whether it was just impromptu.
Now, I'm not saying women are mentally inferior to men, because when it comes to things like cooking and cleaning, washing the potatoes, scrubbing the carrots, raising the babies, mopping the floors, they have it all over men.
I think the only line he would have drawn would have been if he was actually hurting someone. I think a lot of the stuff he did was controversial and enticing and difficult conceptually to understand.
I'd say it's really hard to tell, because it was hard to get him to talk frankly about what he was doing.
He was trying to get other people to say the lines that he had for them to say, but they didn't even know it. That's what I think.
I can't play stoned.
You feel stupid. That's just great. You feel stupid.
I feel stupid.
You feel stupid.
Oh, let's have some bread.
Yeah. Yeah.
What? I feel stupid.
You feel stupid.
I feel very stupid. No, because where are you going?
Well, I think I'm gonna.
This is
all in fun. Come on. All right.
It's all
in fun. What are you trying to do?
This is all.
It's all in fun. Come on.
Where are we now?
Call it.
Cut out.
So you cut it out.
Cut out.
Why do you have to push this in my face?
No.
Why do you have to push this in my face? I'll
put it
all in your face.
This is my big thing in the show. That's why.
Why?
Okay.
So what do you have to scream? What? Look, I'm just trying to have everybody so uptight around here. Everyone is so uptight around here. I don't understand.
Bobby, go to commercial, man.
What? I don't know. Why do you have to be so uptight? What?
Bobby, work up to me.
Friday's thing, to me, is brilliant. To have like a meltdown on a show and get everybody in the media talking about you on a live show. I mean, look what happens when you have a bad performance on Saturday Night Live. People mock you still.
You also have to remember that they were all planned. They weren't him going out and saying, I'm gonna fuck with this crowd so bad, and I'm just gonna do it, and I didn't even think about it. He just did it. No, it wasn't like that at all. It was planned. They were planned to get the responses they got. So my thoughts are they were brilliant, because it very rarely works out that you actually get the response you want to get as a performer, and he did. He knew how to get people to react.
He's in an environment where there's a certain way things are supposed to go, and then he would completely change it. Like when he went on Letterman, and the wrestler Jerry Lawler like slaps him.
Well, no, I didn't, because I'm not that kind of a guy.
Yeah, you know what?
What kind of a guy are you?
No, not the kind of guy.
Obviously, over here. We're going to pause here for station identification and get the hose out of here.
Lasting image is one of like, which leaves people kind of with their head confused. It's a confusing image, I think, and I think that was intentional. I think the intention was confusing.
Andy Kaufman went up there and never told a joke, but just elicited these emotional responses from audiences, and I think that's been his lasting impression on today's comedians and entertainers. You're not handcuffed into going up there and having to go, you know, what's the deal with airline food? Now you can go up there, you know, with blood on your shirt. Never address the reason there's blood on your shirt. And that can be part of your whole piece.
Is he still alive? You didn't think he'd wake up to that question, did you? A woman has come forward claiming to be his daughter. His brother also said that he'd gotten a letter from the comedian saying he'd faked his death and had a family.
So a lot of people think that Andy Kaufman is still alive, and like really recently there was a thing that happened at some sort of award ceremony or some sort of public event, and I can't remember exactly which one it was, but what happened was a woman stepped forward during this show and said that she was Andy Kaufman's daughter and that Andy had had her after he was supposedly dead, and then she sort of disappeared and nothing's come of that since. I think that this is another, honestly, I think it's another stunt. I think it would be, the fact that people believe that Andy Kaufman might still be alive is a testament to how good he was at playing these pranks and playing these characters.
I like the idea that that people think he might still be alive, because that puts him in a group with Tupac, Kennedy, and Elvis. And I think that's a pretty, if the people that don't, people have conspiracy theories that are still alive, if you're part of that group, you're pretty special, because that's like, a president, king of rock and roll, king of hip-hop music, and Andy Kaufman. So that's a pretty elite group, I guess.
So is he alive? No, I hope he's not. Because if he were to come back, there's no way he would be the Andy Kaufman everyone wants him to be. And if he is alive, I hope he's doing whatever he wants, just living a quiet life somewhere, because if he's alive and he faked his death, he pulled off the greatest joke in the history of comedy.
I'm coming home, I did my time, thank you, but I gotta know what is and isn't mine. If you receive my letter telling you I'll soon be free, simple yellow ribbons, what I need to set me free. Yellow ribbon around the old tree. It's been a 3 long years. Do you still want me? If I don't see a yellow ribbon around the old tree, I'll stay on the bus. Forget about us. If I don't see a yellow ribbon around the old oak tree. Slow it down, okay, pal? You want to slow it down a little bit? Okay. I don't know where you get these piano plays from. Bus driver, please, look for me. But I couldn't bear to see what I might see. Hey, my heart is still in prison, and my love, she holds a key. Simple yellow ribbons are what I need, set me free. I wrote and told her, please. I said, now, tuck a yellow ribbon around old tree. Long years, do you still want me? You want to see it again? If I don't see a yellow around the old oak tree, I'll stay on the bus. Forget about us. On me, if I don't see a yellow ribbon around the old oak tree. Wait a minute, wait a minute. Now, old doggone bus is chimney. And I can't believe I see a 100 yellow ribbon around the old tree. Ribbons around the old tree.